This is a production of Cornell University.
I was 6 years old when I brought my first cucumber to my mother. It was withered, yellowing, and approximately 5 or 6 inches in length, but the immense pride I felt was unshaken. Watching the tendrils from the cucumber plant curl around the trellis I provided for it was the first time I was consciously aware of having a love of nature.
Can you believe a 5,000-year-old traditional farming technology has a place in today's high-tech greenhouses? My name is Jonah Helmer, and I'm a sophomore at Cornell University, majoring in plant sciences with a concentration in sustainability and a minor in nutritional sciences. By the year 2050, we're going to need to double the world's food supply in order to feed our growing population. My interest in sustainability has led me to research aquaponics as a possible solution to this problem. I've worked in research projects that assess the difference between hydroponic and aquaponic growing methods. I'm also the vice president of the Cornell Hydroponics Club. I hope to use these experiences to build a career growing sustainable, nutritious, and affordable produce in greenhouses accessible to urban populations.
Hi, my name is Becky Stoke and I'm a student at Cornell. I was first drawn to plant science because of one of the main issues facing today's society, food insecurity. I've long been interested in plant pathology, and I feel like by studying the genetic basis of disease resistance in plants, I can then apply that knowledge using gene editing technology to improve crop yields and therefore increase the total amount of food available to the general public. However, I've noticed a huge disconnect between the public and scientists. People don't know where their food is coming from or anything about the technologies being used to produce it. This is especially evident when it comes to GMOs. A recent survey of consumer attitudes found that ideas such as they're injecting toxic hormones into our foods are still distressingly common. Therefore, I want to study science communications and outreach techniques on top of my plant science education so that I can be more adequately prepared to educate the public throughout my career.
I realize there's so much more to understand about the complex relationships between plants and soils, the microbes that live in these soils, and trees and humans.
Hi, I'm Macy Smith. I'm a freshman plant sciences major at Cornell University. I'm from Cleveland, Ohio, which is where I first was interested in plants. I had an internship at Cleveland Botanical Gardens, and it was there that I realized how much I enjoyed working with and being around plants. Then last year I had the opportunity to travel to Belize with my science class, which is what solidified my choice to study plant sciences. There we met a woman named Aurora. Aurora was called on by her uncle, her village's healer, in their Mayan community to become the village's next healer.
Hi, my name is Michael Marinsky, and I'm a freshman here at Cornell University. One of the reasons why I really love plants is just waking up in the morning and seeing how much they've grown since the last day. Several studies have shown the benefits of plants on mental health, but I also want to examine the multiple benefits of plants on your physical state. I want to bring that relationship between humans and plants to the medical field, and I hope to attend a medical school post-graduation.
The simple activity of helping my family plant a garden in our backyard built a long-term connection. As a Cornell student, I hope that my hands will look as old as they are meant to be.
Hi, I'm Victoria Mock, and I'm a current plant science student here at Cornell, also seeking a minor in business. I grew up in Northern California, and so I'm well aware of scarce resources in regards to agriculture, specifically water in this case, and the challenges they pose on efficient and healthy crop production. I just recently started learning about indoor vertical farms, but already the idea of transforming space where there's virtually nothing into somewhere where you can grow crops efficiently is so appealing to me, mainly because each resource can be tailored exactly to each plant's need, and external factors such as a changing climate and other difficulties like that are essentially gone. These facilities are also highly sustainable because the need for fertilizers and pesticides is eliminated. In the future, I would love to work for one of these indoor vertical farms, helping to improve the crop quality and health, and while also combating the economic challenges such as input costs and facility management.
Hey, my name is Eddie Almanza. I'm a freshman at Cornell University, pursuing a major in plant science and a minor in business. I'm from Trenton, North Carolina, which is very rural and very dependent on agriculture. Since there were so many agricultural jobs, I began working on farms and with various crops such as tobacco, sweet potatoes, cucumbers, and soybeans. For these crops, I mainly just walked behind a tractor replanting the crop or walking through a field pulling out weeds and suckers. Eventually, I went on to work for a farmer in hemp. We grew and harvested the hemp in a greenhouse. and the attention to detail to the pH, temperature, and amount of light needed was incredibly interesting. This led me to realize that I wasn't interested in plants just because I could make money, but I was interested in plants because they were so interesting the way they grew and that we can control the factors that determines how they grow.
Hi, my name is Leor Cole and I'm a freshman at Cornell University. Ever since I was little, I had a fascination with plants, and as I grew up, I was diagnosed with celiac disease, which only increased that fascination. I learned that the wheat crop was being genetically engineered in Spain to grow as a sort of gluten-free wheat, which really piqued my interest. So in high school, I started a club, a plant-focused club, and I got involved with research.
Hi, my name is Lexi Mantilla. I'm a current plant science major at Cornell, and what attracted me to this major was a research experience I had in Maupas National Park, which is 45 kilometers south of Churchill, Manitoba. Interestingly, Churchill has a larger polar bear population than human population. So this was the first time in my life that I was in a place that was largely untouched by humans. It was just miles and miles of land that had all of this natural life and natural beauty. And it was the first time in my life that I was exposed to all of the complexities and the interactions of all of these different forms of life and how they come together. I also learned about what can happen when one of these elements becomes unbalanced and how this can affect people living in that environment.
Hi, I'm Ben Polson. One of my earliest memories is of my dad and I trying to grow a tomato seedling in our backyard. I was only three and he's from the city, so we had no idea what we were doing. The plant died really quickly because we put it in the shadiest spot possible. After that, I was inspired to actually grow plants correctly. I would read seed packets really diligently and plan out all my gardens on graph paper. My gardens got better and better, and in high school, I worked at Wegmans and a community farm where I learned the more industrial side of agriculture. That inspired me to become a plant sciences major at Cornell University, and I want to focus in horticulture and more specifically controlled environment agriculture because I think it would be great to provide sustainable fresh produce to cities all around the world.
Plants are a vital part of the medical field, from pharmaceuticals to their mood-boosting abilities, and I hope to study the relationship better and to learn how to apply this knowledge toward the medical field to improve healthcare and to bring new perspective into the field. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Victoria Zhang and I'm a plant science major planning to concentrate in plant breeding and genetics. Plants have been involved in some of my favorite memories. I remember being a kid, helping my dad in the garden, and being so proud when I picked my first homegrown tomato. Ever since then, I've always been my happiest when working with plants. But I never really got into the scientific aspect of it until one day, two of my succulents were flowering at the same time, and I decided to cross-pollinate them to make my own hybrid. Well, that failed, but I'm still really glad I tried because it opened my eyes to the world of plant breeding. And at Cornell, I realized how much we rely on it. Scientists in the field have to respond to all different kinds of pressures, from our changing culinary tastes to new trends in ornamental plants, and ultimately the future of our food supply, which is threatened by disease and pests.
My name is Justin. I'm currently a sophomore here at Cornell. Ever since I could walk, I was completely captivated by plants. And when I was 10 or 11, I remember I got my first job just sweeping the floors of a greenhouse down the road from where we live, and that was enough to like blow my mind. And then that's how I saved enough money. I was about 13. I built my first greenhouse and became like a survival plant hoarder. That's kind of history. As my interest grew over the next 5 or so years, I decided to come to Cornell, major in plant science. Coming here with the vast resources that SIMS offers, just kind of seemed like the natural next step. And with the rapidly changing climate as well, advances in plant biology are exploding in demand. So for me personally, concentrating my studies in evolution and understanding how plants evolved in the past, I feel, could be a reliable model for predicting how they can be best modified for the future uses of society. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Luke Johnson. I'm a freshman studying plant sciences at Cornell. I first got into plants simply by gardening with my mom and my dad at home. Every year I'd ask my parents to make the garden bigger and bigger, and that's what happened. I decided to study plant science in college because I think we rely so heavily on plants, and there's so much potential for what can be done with them. There's lots of problems facing the world like climate change, population growth, changes in eating habits, and developments in new plant technologies are really going to be necessary in the future, and I think it's the plant scientists that can make that happen.
Hi, My name is Hannah Rudd, and I'm a freshman studying plant sciences at Cornell's College of Agriculture and Life Sciences. I grew up in New York City in a household that really valued hospitality and bringing people joy through food. But growing up in New York City, I also saw the effects of food deserts and not having access to affordable and healthy food. So with a base in plant science, as well as an understanding of food distribution, public policy, and nutrition, I'm really hoping to bring my passion to tangible change in urban areas, which are places that I love.
Hi, I'm Steven Espresso, and I'm a plant science major at Cornell from El Paso, Texas. Nitrogen and phosphorus are two of the main components of fertilizer, and currently they're mostly synthetically produced or mined. But every day, we excrete millions of pounds of these nutrients in our urine, and all it does is go to waste and pollute our drinking water. If we could divert urine, which is just 1% of all sewage waste, farmers could use this as fertilizer. This would be really beneficial because it would conserve water and localize fertilizer production.
This has been a production of Cornell University on the web at cornell.edu.